first question. What's the difference between upstream, midstream, and downstream oil and gas sectors? Upstream sector deals with exploration and production of hydrocarbons. Midstream deals with transportation and storage. And downstream deals with the refining of crude oil. What's the difference between sour and sweet crude oil? Sour crude contains hydrogen sulfide, or H2S, while sweet oil doesn't. Usually, oil with H2S content over 0.5% is considered to be sour. What's some examples of enhanced oil recovery? Thermal recovery, for example, steam injection or SAGD. Chemical flooding, injecting surfactants or polymers to decrease surface tension. Gas injection, using natural gas or carbon dioxide to lower the viscosity of oil and increase its mobility. Microbial injection, using bacteria to increase production and efficiency. What are the most popular artificial lift methods? The first one is sucker rod pump. Downhole plunger is used to displace oil to the surface. The surface engine provides energy to the rod attached to the plunger. Gas lift. This method involves pumping compressed gas to decrease hydrostatic pressure in the well and allow hydrocarbons to flow more easily to the surface. An electric submersible pump, or ESP. It's a downhole centrifugal pump powered by electricity from the surface and usually used on the higher rate wells. Hydraulic pump. This method works by pumping pressurized fluid from the surface to supply energy to the pump downhole. Progressive cavity pump, or PCP. Downhole stator and rotor create a cavity that draws oil to the surface. This the engine is located at the surface and the mechanical force is transferred to the pump by the rotating rod. What is the composition of crude oil? Paraffins make up about 25% of crude oil. Then we have cycloalkanes, 45%, and aromatics make up about 20%. What are some of the properties used to describe reservoir rock? Porosity. The porosity is the amount of void space available in the rock between the rock particles in comparison to the total volume of the rock. Permeability describes how easily the fluid can flow through the rock. Rock compressibility describes how the rock volume is affected by the changes in pressure. Fluid saturation, the volume of particular fluid in comparison to the total pore volume. Wettability describes how the fluids behave on the surface of the rock. What's the API gravity of crude oil and how it's calculated? API stands for American Petroleum Institute, and it's used to demonstrate how the density of crude oil compares to the density of water and can be calculated using this equation. What are the casing and cementing? Casing involves running a steel pipe into the well to prevent the hole collapse, allow more well control, and isolate high and low pressure zones. Cementing involves filling the space between the casing pipe and the walls of the drilled hole with cement to stabilize the wellbore and prevent the formation fluids from contaminating the groundwater. What are the three types of reservoir recovery? Primary, conventional oil recovery driven by reservoir pressure. Secondary, injecting water or gas to increase reservoir pressure and push hydrocarbons toward the producing well. Tertiary, or enhanced oil recovery, injecting chemicals or increasing reservoir temperature to decrease oil viscosity and increase sweeping efficiency. What's the difference between enhanced oil recovery and hydraulic fracturing? Hydraulic fracturing is usually done right after the well is drilled and is used to create fractures in the tight formation, such as shale, to create additional pathways for hydrocarbons to flow toward the wellbore. Enhanced oil recovery, on the other hand, is usually performed on older wells by injecting chemicals or increasing temperature to change the oil properties and make it more mobile. What's gas flaring and why it's performed? Gas flaring is a burning of natural gas released during oil extraction or refining process. It's performed to dispose of smaller volumes of unwanted natural gas that cannot be used economically on location or shipped to the refinery. What are the main factors affecting oil prices? Production costs. How much it costs to get the oil out of the ground. Transportation costs. The price of oil depends on where the oil is located and how easy it is to get to consumer. Type of oil. Sweet lighter oil will be sold at a premium in comparison to heavier sour oil. Supply and demand. High demand and low supply will drive the price of oil up. Market speculations, fears and rumors can move the price of oil in both directions. What's pipeline pigging? Pipeline pigging is the process of using a pig to inspect, clean or repair a pipeline. The pigs are usually pushed down the pipeline by the energy of the fluid flowing through the pipeline. Pigs come in various shapes and sizes depending on the job requirements, but in most cases they have a cylindrical shape. They are made of soft, durable materials such as rubber, plastic or foam. Explain how natural gas is formed. Natural gas formed deep underground from the decomposition of organic matter, such as dead plants and animals. It's a very slow process and it takes millions of years for natural gas to form this way, because organic matter needs to be buried and slowly pushed deeper and deeper underground until the right conditions are met. There, under high temperatures and pressure, this organic matter is slowly converted into the natural gas. What are some examples of how natural gas is used? Natural gas is used for cooking food, heating water, generating electricity, transportation, chemical synthesis, welding metals, making fertilizers, hydrogen and for hydrogen generation. What is coal bed methane? Coal bed methane, or CBM, is natural gas trapped in underground coal deposits. Methane is either trapped as a free gas dissolved in water or absorbed into the coal. What are some examples of well logging and why it's performed? Gamma ray logging, used to detect natural radiation emitted by deformation. This can be used to distinguish between different reservoir rocks and determine reservoir thickness. Sonic logging, used to measure how fast the sound travels through the formation. This can be used to calculate porosity and the type of rocks in the formation. Spontaneous potential logging, used to determine the porosity of formation. Caliper logging, used to measure the size of the hole. Resistivity logging, performed to determine the resistivity of the formation rock. Density logging, used in determining the porosity of the formation. Neutron logging, performed by emitting neutrons from the tool and then determining how they interact with the formation. What is MWD? Measurement while drilling, or MWD, is used to get real-time information about wellbore trajectory as well as other downhole data. This data is sent via pressure pulses to the surface, where it's received by surface transducers. What are methane gas hydrates? Methane gas hydrates are formed when methane is combined with water at low temperatures and high pressure. The methane molecules don't chemically react with water to create gas hydrates, but instead are bonded to the water with hydrogen bonds. After gas hydrate is formed, it can stay relatively stable even at higher temperatures and lower pressures. What's H2S and why it's so dangerous? Hydrogen sulfide is colorless toxic gas that smells like rotten eggs at low concentrations of about 0.1 ppm. It's highly toxic, can be lethal even in small quantities over 500 ppm, making it extremely dangerous. It acts by paralyzing the respiratory system. H2S is also a very flammable gas and can damage metals by allowing hydrogen to diffuse into the metal and making it weaker and easier to break. This is known as hydrogen embrittlement. What are the main ways to transport crude oil? The four main ways to transport crude oil are using oil tankers, pipelines, trucks, and rail. What is the difference between Brent and WTI crude oil? WTI is a light sweet crude oil that comes from the oil fields in the US and is stored at the Cushing, Oklahoma. Brent is a bit heavier and slightly more sour and comes from the various fields in the North Sea. What are some examples of how oil is extracted from the oil sands? Surface mining. This is done by using large trucks that load oil sand and transport it to facilities where it undergoes processing to separate the oil from the sand by heating it up with water. Steam-assisted gravity drainage, or SAGD. This is an in-situ oil sand recovery method that involves drilling two wells just a few meters apart from each other. One of the wells is used for steam injection and the other one is for oil production. Cold heavy oil production with sand, or CHOPS. This method is similar to conventional horizontal well drilling operations, with the only difference being is that sand filters are not installed and the sand is allowed to flow into the wellbore along with the heavy oil. Cyclic steam stimulation, or CSS. Steam is injected into the well for a long period of time to heat up the formation. After the steam injection is stopped, the well is put in production. And the last method is vapor extraction, or VAPEX. Similar to SAGD, but instead of a steam, various solvents and a liquid gas are injected into the upper well to dissolve bitumen and allow it to flow into the lower producing well. What's the three types of permeability? Absolute permeability describes how the single fluid flows through the reservoir rock. This assumes that there is only one type of fluid in the reservoir. Effective permeability describes how the flow of particular fluid in the rock when there is another fluid present, for example, describing how oil flows through the rock when there are both oil and water in the reservoir. Relative permeability describes the ratio between effective permeability and absolute permeability. What are some examples of chemicals used in hydraulic fracturing? Friction reducers used to lower pumping pressures. Gelic agents used to increase the viscosity of fracturing fluid to improve its sand carrying capacity. Breakers used to break down the gel and prevent formation damage. Biocides used to get rid of bacteria in the fracturing fluid that can potentially create unwanted byproducts like H2S and damage formation and equipment. Non-emulsifiers. They help to prevent emulsions between frac fluid and formation fluids. Acids. Acids are pumped before the frac to prepare the perforations and formation for the frac. What's LNG? LNG is natural gas, which is methane, compressed and cooled to transform into liquid form. By compressing natural gas, its volume can be decreased by up to 600 times, which makes it much easier to transport and send to the consumers. What is hydraulic fracturing? Hydraulic fracturing basically means creating small pathways in a formation that allow hydrocarbons like oil and gas to flow more easily into the wellbore of producing well. This is achieved by injecting large volumes of fluid and sand under pressure into the formation to break the rock and create high permeability fractures. Fracturing is often performed in tight formations such as shale, which have extremely low permeability. What is the purpose of an oil refinery? Oil refineries are used to process crude oil into useful products like fuel, lubricants, and petrochemicals. The refining process includes various methods such as fractional distillation, hydrotreating, and catalytic cracking. What are OPEC and OPEC Plus? OPEC stands for Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries, which is a cartel of 13 nations that control a significant portion of global crude oil production. OPEC Plus is a union of OPEC and non-OPEC countries, such as Russia or Mexico, that work together to manage global crude oil supply and control oil prices. What is the blowout preventer? Blowout preventer, or BOP, is a safety device used to prevent and control the release of hydrocarbons during drilling and intervention operations. Most BOPs usually have metal-type rams that either seal around the pipe in the well or cut it and hold in place until it can be safely removed after the well is under control. Four most common types of rams used in BOPs are pipe rams. They seal around the pipe, preventing the well fluids from coming to the surface. Blind rams seal the well bore when there is no pipe in the well. Shear rams. They cut to the pipe and fully seal the wellbore. Slip rams. They prevent the pipe from falling into the well or being pushed upward by the well pressure. So here are the 30 questions that you might be asked on your next oil and gas interview. Obviously, depending on your position, you might face other questions directly related to your role. They might be about the specific operating system, software, or hardware used in your role. You might also face questions that are focused on safety procedures and regulations, production processes, and even project management skills. So you should prepare for those as well. Thank you for watching this video, and please don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you guys later. Bye.